So the key concerns of emerging new variants, I would like to repeat. First is virus transmissibility, that it is transmissible easily. For example, 617 is 50 times more transmissible than the UK variant. Then it can increase to disease severity, but most of them have not shown to be serious in nature. Then it can cause immune escape, that is, it can increase reinfections in the persons. Then it can affect vaccine effectiveness, but luckily, most of them do not cause any problem with vaccines. So all the vaccines which we are using in India, like Covaxin or Covishield, are effective against all the variants. So we need not fear for that. But new variants, how do they form? They form as a natural consequence. Secondly, they can be hastened by certain antibodies which are present in our body. So what is the response to this particular variants happening in all over the world? At a world level, we are responding it by a very important group of World Health Organization called the SARS-CoV-2 Interagency Group, that is SIG. Then there are various other agencies which deal with the variants. Genomic surveillance is the most important thing here. Random sample testing of various isolates which are there can help you in finding a new variant. In India, we have a very specific activity against finding of variants, and that is a consortium which is formed by Government of India, which is called as INSACOG. It stands for Indian SARS-CoV-2 Consortium on Genomics. It was set up by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, on 25th of December 2020 as a consortium of 10 national laboratories. It is all laboratories are required to share 5% of positive samples with INSACOG, and this particular organization tries to detect for variants if they are found in Indian population.